everyone, welcome to my updated workspace tour at last. It's been 3 years since I started YouTube and my first proper video was in fact a tour of my workstation. And I think to symbolise my third anniversary on YouTube, which is coming up on the 31st of January, why not do an updated workstation tour? So it's changed a lot. If you check out the description, it will have the link to the old one, but make sure you watch this one first. It's very outdated. I think the major changes are that we moved house and that I have two beds now. Believe it or not, I didn't even have Bumble in the first one that I did. So there was like a space and I was like my friend Helen said today, she said, and here is where I would put a bird if I had one. But yeah, the lighting's kind of spooky and off, but it's nice and bright for filming this kind of video. So yeah, you can see my room like this first. It's a good job I don't have roots anymore. So that's my room, guys. That's the end of the video, no. I'm going to start with my desk, which is over there. And this is going to be a long one, so get yourself a cup of tea or some snacks or whatever. Stick this video on and I hope you enjoy it. If you hear some weird crinkly noises, it's my heater. It's too hot now. So I'm going to sit down at my desk. This is where the magic happens, and also my drawings. So, yeah, I have a tower PC. I use Windows 7. This is a Wacom Cintiq 21 UX, and it's basically been replaced by the 22 HD. I use things like Photoshop and Paint Tool Sai. I have an insane amount of stickers around it. Which I don't mind doing. None of it actually touches the active area, so if you want to put stickers on yours, just make sure you don't put it on the drawing area. I also have a 32-inch television. This is our old 3D HD TV. We now have some bigger TVs, so I decided to bring this one in here. I would like three monitors, but my graphics card doesn't support it because it's too old. So that's a little bit embarrassing. This is my PC tower. It's a thermal take and it's in like an arctic white colour and I love it so much that I stuck a bee on it. And I'll show you inside when we get around there. But yeah, so this is my desk. I sit here and do my artwork here. This is my webcam that points down off this thing. This is kind of like a monopod. I had to search, Ryan recently broke my monopod that I'd had for 3 years. He was trying to fix it, but he accidentally glued it together, so I had to buy a new one. It was only about £10, and I'll give you the link to eBay if I can locate another one, because I know a lot of people quite like this, but it has to take a very light camera. So, I have a wireless keyboard, which is really pretty. It's got all these designs on it, and also a bat sticker that I stuck on. And I have a mouse, which has lollipops on. And yeah, so if any of you guys want, I will put links in the description for Amazon for the things that I've got, so you can go and check them out. I have a mouse pad by Kira on Magibubble here on YouTube. She's incredible, go check her out, I love her so much. So yeah, she's got an incredible art style and she's got an art channel, so go look at her. And she goes on trips to Japan and she's so cool. So. That's my phone, which has a case from Redbubble on. I have an iPhone 6S, and the background is by Denny or Dement09 on Tumblr. She's really awesome. And I don't know what my lock screen is, I forgot. Headphones that I still have these. These are so old. I painted these when I was still in Hong Kong, so these are about 5 years old. And they're falling apart, but they still work. My main water tub is a cranberry sauce jar because my close friends know how much I love cranberry sauce. I really like cranberry sauce. I go nuts for it. So I have a lot of jars of cranberry sauce lying around. So this one became my new water jar. And it's got dirty water in. Because I've only just finished painting last night. So... So my pencil case, you can see my video on what's inside my pencil case. I'll put a link in the description to that as well. I also have a cup of tea in this Boss mug. I just noticed that. Things like hairbrush, my Wacom pen is in a holder which is stuck inside a Totoro. And there's my smudge guard glove, which I use to... I wear this when I am drawing on the Cintiq because your hand glides better. I actually... It's not a necessary purchase, but I can't use it without because it heats up so much and my hand sticks and it's not as smooth to draw on without it. That's a bandana, remote for my TV, and then I've got some like little things. I do my makeup in here now. I normally do it when I'm starting a live stream, but it's also warmer in here than the rest of the house, so I do my makeup in here now. So I've got some dry shampoo, some moisturiser, some hand sanitizer. I've got this amazing candle was from Game Tea. It's not very arty so far, but you know, it'll fluctuate in and out because this is the room that I pretty much live in. I do live in a large flat, but I spend a lot of time working in here. This is my workroom, this is my life, this is what I do. Some little bits in a little jar here. This is a lamp that I got from Hobbycraft. It's got a daylight bulb in it and it's really good. My Simon's Cat calendar that was reduced because I buy calendars after New Year because I'm cheap. But it's really cute. It's a desk calendar. I've never had a desk calendar before, so yeah. A little tub of putty that a friend sent me on a Secret Santa. And a little crocheted pumpkin that I got as a gift too. So these drawers are absolutely gorgeous. The sides are like full mirror. And I got this for Christmas from my aunt and cousin. And it's so nice. All the inside is like velvety. So in here, ignore my old phone. I don't know why I have that in there. Wow, there's going to be a lot of that. Anyway, in here I have my tumblestones. And these are like healing crystals because I'm kind of researching that lately. I also have an aventurine pendant, which I want to make into a necklace. I have a cage for necklaces. I've got a ring that's shaped like a diamond, which I got from my friend Lauren. I love wearing this ring. A random USB stick, a jade bracelet, and I also keep some other bits in here as well to do with crystals. I have a small crystal collection actually. And then in here is just like basic desk things. So I've got full dog clips, bird shaped paper clips from Andreas. I've got some wooden stamps, some post-it notes because I live off post-it notes, stamping pads, just misc stuff. In the bottom, I have some headphones, my lipsticks, which are all various shades of red. I have a necklace with flower yarn from Undertale. I have a little ring light that plugs into my phone, which is so cute, and Fiona bought me it, and she's amazing. A card reader, and just some other daft little bits. Oh, I also keep all my bobby pins in here, if you could just see them in there, because I use a lot of bobby pins in my hair. I didn't this time, though. Oh, and this sparkly thing has my washi tapes in. I'm not going to bother showing you, because, I don't know, should I? Yeah, okay. You want to see it? This is going to be a very full-on workspace tour. These are all my washi tapes. My favourite is the Kakeshi doll. There we go. Moving on to this side, I have my planner for things like YouTube and jobs and work and things like that. And then I have my little planner which has budgies on. And this is my personal planner for things like, I keep my medication in this, I put doctor's appointments down, tax returns, tax information, things like that. And then I have a goals journal that Fiona got me for Christmas, which is really cute, and it's like shiny gold as well on the front, and that's my aesthetic. And then you're going to hear a lot of, and this friend bought me this, because I get so many gifts from people, it's incredible. I just have the best friends in the world, they're so sweet. This was a gift from Fiona when I recently went to visit her. She put loads of pens in it, but I've actually been really naughty. And it's my new makeup bag, because I've needed one for ages, and it's so pretty. And I felt it would get even more use as a makeup bag, and I would see it more often. So I have my eyeshadow palette, a brown sketchbook, some fishnet tights. I think they're for a cosplay, I can't remember. Some cards that need to go in my purse, and this desk set, which is incredible, and I'm going to kind of see if you can see that. Mel sent me this all the way from Canada. She's really sweet, and I actually want to open this as an ASMR video, because like it makes really nice sounds, so that's going to be an ASMR video. Deodorant, nail varnish remover, a random thing for convention display. Then I have a cutting mat, painting that I just finished. The video is going to be up for this, I think, already by the time I upload this one. So, and then a 6x8 watercolour paper, that's the same paper that this was done on, and it's by Fluid, but you'll get to see all my papers later. And my house phone, and that is pretty much my desk, and I've clipped something, whoops. You see that my backgrounds change. I have a lot of artwork that's Steven Universe screenshots, or artwork by, like, that. The previous one was Cora by Irene Coe, and she's the comic artist for the Legend of Cora comics that are coming out in June. Yeah, so if you've seen things scroll past, there's like Rebecca Sugar's artwork, there's storyboards from Steven Universe, there's artwork that people have done for me, there's fan art that I like, you know, it's just, it's total trash. Like, good trash, like fandom trash, you know, that kind of trash. And then, okay, there's Overwatch ships. Okay. So, some of you know that I have a beautiful collection of artwork on my walls that you might have seen in photographs, or you might have seen this wall in my videos. So we're going to do a wall tour as well. So I'm going to do this section first, and then when we get over here, I'll talk about what's on there. So we'll start here and work all the way around. So this is a print by Denny again. Like how I said, it was on my phone background. Dement09. On Tumblr, she's amazing. She does a lot of Human AU Lapidot stuff, which I really recommend. It's so good, and her art style is just like, oh, just, yep. And this is a human version of Peridot, and I got this for my birthday. Andreas actually ordered it for my birthday from her, so and she's really incredible, so go check her out. She also has a YouTube channel, and I think we're doing like an art trade soon, so that would be awesome if you could go check her out. Here, there's a blank space here where I had a Fire Emblem print by my friend Nikki, and it falls down all the time, it needs to be framed. here I have my signed Loish print. I backed her Kickstarter early enough to get the signed print, so it's also wonky, gross, but it's absolutely stunning, I love it so much. There's also bits of blue tack on the wall, you know, keeping it classy. And then this is a drawing by my friend Jazz, who I've kind of lost contact with her, unfortunately. She was one of my best friends a few years ago, and she drew my my character, who has now turned into Zach. Yeah, and then this was made by Sarah, as in I think she's changed her YouTube name, but I will link it in the description. She's incredible, and she has a little boy named well, she calls him Squirrel, and I don't want to call him Squirrel, but he's so sweet. And yeah, he's called Leo, but they're such a cute family, and they have the cutest videos, so go check them out. And then here's my corkboard of awesome, as I dubbed it. I mean, it used to just be this corkboard and nothing else, and then it kind of went a bit mad. So I have, here's some drawings done by my friend Steph. We did blindfold drawings. If you remember, I did blindfold Cora, she did blindfold Miku, and then she drew an actual Miku. This is a Cora digitally drawn by my friend Amy, who is my best friend in uni, and still is one of my best friends, obviously. We have a Pearl, drawn by Sophie, or Sophia Lou. We've got one of Bailey J's prints. I can't see the camera right now. My arm hurts already. This is Chrissy's drawing. I love this so much. We have Maxie's artwork. This is really old now, actually. What does it say? Oh my god, September 2013, that's when I first met them. And there's a drawing of me. This one is by, oh my god, okay, my arm really hurts. This one's by Zumi, And then I have an alien isolation fan art of me hiding in a locker. This is by Claire. Oh, I've accidentally zoomed in. Wow, I'm such a professional. This is also drawn by Max, a lot more recently. And then we have a link, and there's some more of Kira's work. And oh, there's just so much. I've got Joyce Anne originals there. Like, there's a drawing of me. I can't even see it. There's a Bailey J one there, and then there's just lots of really nice things on this board. This is by Nikki as well, and she drew Coronasami. And then I have a signed drawing. I drew the Stefani, and it's signed by Stefani's voice actress. I got to meet her. I'll stick a photo up of when I met her, and I gave her a watercolour drawing, and it was so emotional, and I was a crying fangirl, and it was so embarrassing, but you know. And then we have an original by Brogan Coral, and it's Jasper. This is before I was even like a big fan of Jasper. I'd only sort of just recently got into Steven Universe, and the only favourites I had were Pearl and Peridot. And Peridot was like not even her current form, Peridot. So that's how far back we're going. Somebody wears a mask. And then this is a watercolour by Nikki, or you might know her online as Kidura. This is an original, guys. Like, I have the original. I cherish this with my life. You have no idea. She painted this for me, and I cried when I received it because I wasn't expecting it, and I just... Oh, okay. I have a letter here that was given to me by a Jamie cosplayer at MCM Manchester. So, Jamie cosplayer, if you're watching... and then there's a print by my friend Steph, who drew the Mikus. Okay, we're on to the frames. Okay, so these frames here, the ones that all have the same art style, were drawn by Laura Howell, I think is her name. She works on the Regular Show comics. She is absolutely amazing, and I have two customised comic covers by her, and I'm such a big fan of hers, and I always show up weird... like this weird fangirl at conventions. I'm like, I buy all your prints. And I'm just, oh, such a weirdo. Going from right to left, we have Alex's work. It says, "We love you, Morgan." Cry. Got a Journey postcard. We've got Steven Universe print, Tyrant art, also drawn by Alex. A Bailey print. And then this by, I think, they go by the name Robin, or they did. They're on my Facebook. And they're really awesome. And I can't remember their artist name, but they might have changed it, actually. Then I have Undyne, Flowey, Beyonce, Peebs, and Marceline, Opal, and Jasper. I'm so out of breath. Ah! Okay. Behind here, which unfortunately gets cut off, but I didn't plan for it to get cut off, is a drawing that Ryan did for me. It's an original of Kanji, and I love it so much. And I think I'm going to move this, because I've got some spare adhesive strips now. I'm going to move it to over here so I can actually see it. We have the pearls. This was a gift by Toasted Bagels. And we have me. And then, look, Bat Malachite. This was from Amy when I hit 50k. And then I have these from Claude, who is just incredible and like 12 years old or something, and his work is just... What? Okay. We have Audra O'Claire print. And another one. You're going to see a running theme, trust me. We've got this Opal and this Kurosami by Alex and an Asami by Joy-san. And... Oh my god, I love my art wall so much. It makes me so happy. I've collected so much art that I love, and it really makes me happy. I'm glad that I put this much effort and money into it. And then we have an Overwatch poster. I stuck my... Whoa! Wow, you've just witnessed. Okay, I didn't put enough command hooks. I've just put this up, actually. Oh dear. Oh dear. I give it 5 minutes and that one's gonna fall off. Anyway, I have my Overwatch poster and I put that pride flag up there when it was announced that Tracer was gay. So there you go. I didn't have anywhere else to put it and I thought that actually fits. Okay, so we have, this is my tower, like I said. You can't even see inside it now. I have glowy lights. My subwoofer is here and then I have like this letter stack thing. It has some envelopes, some cellophane bags and stuff. This is a folder. Oh no, I'm gonna sneeze. This little box folder has all my paperwork for Canada in it. I have my light box, which is super thin and hides away. And I have a spare drawing mat down there as well. I have my box of A3 prints in here. And a painting that I'm not gonna finish. Some bubble mailers and stuff in here. And this is kind of like my postage area, so I'm still waiting on a lot of stuff coming in. I just received my postage labels today, which I wasn't expecting at all, but I still don't have my postal mark or anything like that, or they haven't set up my direct debit yet either, so I'm kind of like, what's happening? For those that don't know, I'm applying for a business account, so if anyone's not received their package yet, that's why. I'm waiting on sending out post through a business service rather than a public service, but yeah. So I have my charms and stuff, like I make Steven Universe charms. Of course I pick out Jasper. So each one has like a precious stone on, the charm. So Jasper actually has real Jasper. I picked brown zebra Jasper because it's stripey like her, and then like garnet has a garnet, and you get the idea. Pearl has a pearl, amethyst has an amethyst. I really like the pearls actually, and you could get these in my online store as well if you fancy getting one. They are freshwater pearls, it's so cool. And I also have some of my OCs, so this is Zach from Transfer. And she has a honey jade, and then there's Otia, who has a peridot. And then I have like a box of little random gifts that I'm going to put in free with orders, some stickers and spare prints and stuff. And under here I've got like mystery bags, things that I'm going to, old convention stock that I'm going to put in for free with orders. In here there are full board envelopes, white ones. Under here I have my books, my printed zines, my printed comics and stuff. And then in here are my, I think I've already said, these are my A3 prints. They're in a big box. And then I have, this is a painting of me and Mel playing Pokemon, which I need to finish. And then this box has my mini prints in. Down there is just a general tip. And then I have this section here. Also, apologies if I'm talking too fast. I am trying to cover so much, and I don't want this video to be like 2 hours long, because I could easily make it like 2 to 5 hours long, and you don't want that. If you do, hit me up and I might refilm it. This is kind of like where I keep most of my comics. Actually, I think all my comics, apart from a very small amount elsewhere. But yeah, so I have a framed Pikachu EX card, which is beautiful. I love that so much. These are the SDCC zines that Lauren Zook and Mira W did. Ta-da! And my friend Matt picked these up. So I have like 52 of 258. They're pretty low numbers. Lots of peridot and it's great. And these were drawings by Sketchy Cat here on YouTube. And she gave me them at the start of last year at Liverpool Comic Con. And there's a video you can watch of her showing you these drawings. And she's so sweet. And she came to meet me and I nearly cried. yeah, so I have on here my little collection. I have, Audra sent me this Pearl original, because she's a superstar. I love her so much. And it's absolutely stunning. And I cried. And I wasn't expecting it. Her originals are absolutely flawless. And I feel so blessed that she took the time to draw that for me. There's a jasper and a pearl that someone gave me at London. I love it so much. It's an original as well. I have a little box of cards from the Lowish Kickstarter. A fairy doll named Bubblegum that Danny bought for me. And a pair of glasses that I'm going to use for my Wick cosplay. I have an ocelot from Minecraft. Tamayo from CCS. The Lunala and Solgaleo figures that came with the pre-order of the game. And a Pearl Funko Pop. The only Funko Pop I own. And she doesn't stay up very well. But. So I'll go left to right. I'm just standing on things I shouldn't be. So here's my little Steven Universe book collection. I have Postcard Power. The Answer. Live from Beach City. I have a. The Crystal Gem Club Zine. Which was run by. Oh my gosh, what's her name? Jenna Brown, yeah. Cyanatar, I think her name is, on Twitter. And then I have Quest for Gem Magic. Like, most of these I just collect to have for the collection, not use them or anything. Guide to the Crystal Gems, which has a really nice sparkly cover. I have Too Cool for School, which is gorgeous. That cover is just stunning. I have the two volumes, the Kaboom release, not the UK release. So I've got volume 1 and 2 of the Steven Universe comics. I have Marceline Gone Adrift, Paper Girls, which is one of my favourites, and I just got number 2 for Christmas, but I haven't read it yet. Giant Days, which I got at the same time. Marceline and the Scream Queens. The first three Lumberjanes, Sunstone, Steven Universe Mad Libs, which should be over there, but it isn't. Oops. And then The Secret Loves of Geek Girls, which I pre-ordered. And then I have Brian Lee O'Malley's Seconds, Our Super Adventure by Sarah Grayley, who's incredible, and she signed it to me. Scott McCloud's The Sculptor, The Lost Adventures, the Avatar comics. I don't actually own any of the other Avatar comics, because I'm an idiot. I really need to buy them. The Avatar Legacy book, which is super sweet. And then Princess, which I love this webcomic so much. And I have never pre-ordered anything faster, I don't think, other than my Majora's Mask 3DS. So the artwork's stunning by Katie O'Neill. Check it out. It's so, so cute. And then I have The Art of Lowish, is amazing. Up here I have my single issues of my zines that I've collected, sketchbooks from artists. I'm not going to go through all of them. I'll just pick a few out at random. Ayala's, this one is, what's her art name? Porcelain, yes. And I'll link you to all of these artists. There's Jess Taylor's, Audra's, of course, absolutely stunning. If you can get a copy of Mayume, I think it's, is it Mayume? Masayume, yeah. I always get it wrong. But it's her sketchbook from when she went through Japan, and I read it cover to cover, so it's absolutely stunning. This is probably one of my favourite books I own, and this is Frontier by Rebecca Sugar. And it's sketches from her unreleased comic, and she's such a huge influence on me, and it was incredible seeing this stuff, and I feel very inspired every time I read it, so it's good to have around. What else have I got? Here are my here's my customised regular show comic by Laura Howell. I've got The Last Airbender Free Comic Book Day. I also have the core one there. What have I got? Being Puppy Cat, some of the Being Puppy Cat singles. Steven Universe issue 1 and issue 2. This one signed by the artist. Thank you, Max. Overwatch Anna comic that Matt got me from SCCC. I got a customised Steven Universe comic drawn by Laura Howell. And I requested Jasper. Of course. I've got the foldings, which I backed on Kickstarter. And I have Nikki's first manga. It's called Swordless. Oh my god, if you want to know why I got into watercolours, this is the artist. She is the sweetest person alive, and she is so talented. I love her to bits. Khan's 2016 sketchbook. Then I have a little folder full of, like, artwork and letters that I've been sent, which is so cute. But the log date zine, which has just arrived. I have some cards that for birthdays coming up. Madoka Magica Volume 1, and then I have some, just a binder there, and a crystal healing guide thing there. And then underneath I have some notebooks, a colouring paper. Ooh, there's a present for Andreas. I've got, oh my gosh, presents for people, don't look! And then little drawers, so I've got things like bank security things. Various little bits in here. There's a spare Jasper. What are you doing in there? Jasper is everywhere, okay? And then I have my glue. I have some spare badges. I was given that Jake at Birmingham. This guy just came up to me. And then some, yeah, just notebooks and stuff. And here I have a jewellery box that has all my earrings in. My ears aren't pierced yet, but it's also got all my patches and stuff in, so I really like that little box. And I have these, which I haven't put in yet. Hold that back. Ow! So I got this little chest of drawers from, I live near a furniture store, and Ryan's on good speaking terms with the guy, so he got this drawer. I think it was like a tenner, and the other white one, I'm not sure. But they're really deep and really good for, it fits like A3 paper, so I'm really happy with these. So I've got a lot of stuff. Some thank you cards to put into orders. A cash box, some other bits, some original drawings that I need to frame and put up. Jasper by Tashi Cake. Oh, I love it so much. She just drew it and I watched her draw it. She was sat next to me and I just fell in love. The drawing is just so good. And then there's a journey piece by my friend Amy. I don't know what else is in there. Some Halloween decorations I didn't get to using. Got a hair bow, like paired up themed hair bow. Some other stuff. Calculator. Just, yeah, random bits. I have a few random spaces that just, you know, aren't really anything particular. So here's more board envelopes. Have a present. And there's some postal tubes for things like large print. So you see how deep and useful these drawers are? So good. And I think these are just bedroom drawers. So if you're looking for art storage, look for like actual furniture rather than art themed furniture, because it can be really expensive to find like drawers for craft rooms and stuff. So always go check out thrift stores, charity shops and stuff. So this is my paper drawer. Oh, I love this drawer. So I have blank sketch pads. These are all my watercolour pads. I've got watercolour, newsprint, more watercolour. Are we seeing a theme yet? Sketch paper, and then some larger paper at the bottom. Oh, I've got Bristol boards. Wow, I've got canvas boards. Okay, and then I have my small watercolour paper here. So I've got Fluid 654, which is my favourite. Cold press with the red cover is my favourite. And then I have some hot press. And then underneath I have some blank notebooks to do, to customise. I have a... Ow, I was just... This is my oil painting box, so big brush on top. Yeah, you can't really see into it, but I have artisan water soluble oils, because I can't use traditional oils because of the birds. Some spare planner sheets, and then here's my inks that I miss using very much and I wish I used them more often. Watercolours have ruined my life. So as well, I have a laser printer that's really on its way out. It's very broken. it's nothing special. It's a colour laser. It's very expensive and I don't want to replace it because colour lasers are very expensive. So I have a very conveniently placed Hoover, not like I was feverishly tidying before this video or anything. So this is what I use for the background of my YouTube video. So you only kind of see this because down there is a mess and I just have like piles of stuff that I can't be bothered. I'm going to be honest, I can't be bothered dealing with it all right now. That's what that section is for. It's a lot of old convention stuff and I haven't had time to really get to grips with it. I'm going to tackle that at the end of next month, I think. But anyway, so I have my other little collection that I'm very proud of and I'll just give a sweep over because I can't talk about everything. Some Steven Universe stuff, Pokemon, my favourite Pokemon. And can you guess what my favourite Pokemon is? So I love these little charms that Mel got me as well. So sweet. Here's some of my crystals. I've just realised that my crystals are actually on my crystal grid at the moment. So yeah, I'm not going to disturb them. I have a canvas that Kat painted, Mario cushion, Chikrita, wooden squirrel, which I love so much. I have a Lego burb that I got for Christmas, a Naga plush, and a Pachimaru, which I'm sure it makes a noise. Yep. Okay. I have another little pride flag. My ukulele, it doesn't stay there. I just thought it looked edgy. It looked cool there, okay? So, yeah, I sit and I practice the ukulele. I also have an Adventure Time ukulele that my friend Ash bought me for my birthday. It's so out of tune because I don't play it. Yeah. Wowee. But it is just for, I want to get some hooks and put it on the wall properly, but it is purely for decoration at this point. So I have some artwork as well, it's by Jess. I can never remember the name of this artist and I feel really bad. It's very difficult for me to remember all the gift art that I've got. I'm so sorry if I forget. So I've got like Holtzman, some baseball gems, Bob, some pearl beads, pearls, done by my friends at Retro8Bit. And also if you saw my necklace, that was also done by them, and the peridot. And then I have a 3D printed rose quartz by Chompworks. Print by Sophia Liu. if anyone knows what this is, you know, leave a comment if you know. I have a perpetual calendar, which means it doesn't have dates on, so I can have it for as long as I want, and it's the birthstones of each month, which is really sweet. Rose quartz by Brogan Coral, and then another porcelain print of opal. And then I have some lights and some bats. Bats are actually my favourite animal. So the more you know about me, eh? And then I just have some posters. So this is an Adventure Time one, obviously. I have some Zelda ones, Persona 4 print, Ariel in a bottle. I love that so much. Drawn by Andreas, Bumble Dorable, when I actually got Bumble. February 2014 is when I got Bumble. And then this little ditto by Max. And then I was at the very first Legend of Zelda 25th Anniversary Symphony and I saw some incredible people that night. And I will never, ever, you know, I almost don't want to go to another Zelda concert because I don't want this to ever feel different. It was such a one-time event. There was Zelda Williams, there was Iwata, there was, was it Aonuma? I can't remember. I think it could have been Aonuma and Koji Kondo. And it was just the most magical night I'll ever have. And I got engaged there, Ryan proposed. So I have a official promo poster of Majora's Mask and the poster that came with the limited edition, because guess what my favourite game series is? It's Zelda. So I can't really talk much about this, but this is my little Zelda shrine. I joke about this, but I always say my favourite piece of my collection is that right there, that orange disc. Do you know what that is? That's the Wand of Gamelon, guys. And I was so lucky to get it in the charity shop for free because they were going to chuck it out. But some of my Zelda stuff there. And then I have the 30th anniversary amiibos. I didn't get the fourth one, I wasn't that keen on it. I have a Zelda journal, and then some of my 3DS boxes. I don't keep the games in there, just the boxes. More Zelda stuff, so these are all my Zelda books. I have some of the collector's edition. I have more than this, but I don't know where I've put them. I've got the Japanese Hyrule Warriors book, which was amazing. Twilight Princess HD, 25th anniversary 3DS, which is in that pouch, and Twilight Princess on the Wii, because I couldn't get up there. And then I have some more limited edition boxes. I got Amiibo Festival. I know the game sucked, but I really wanted the two Amiibos and the whole box and everything. So Yoshi's Woolly World, and Steven Universe Monopoly. This sort of urn thing that my nana got for my 21st birthday, and it's lovely. Like Japanese style. And it's dusty. I have Super Smash Bros. For Wii U, which came with the GameCube port. And I have a GameCube and a SNES. And these are going to be... I'm actually going to hook up the capture card so I can play these on livestream. Which would be fun. And I have the Game Boy player on the bottom. And then I have some little charms here. Like some of them are jade and they were bought in Hong Kong when I lived there. We have a dragon, a rabbit, a horse. And these were made by my friend in Hong Kong. And chilies. So, I have another small collection here. So I have a Lucina amiibo because I love Lucina. Some Pokemon toys, some other little bits and knickknacks. My betrothal necklace. So, yeah, and there's Sarah Squirrel, who's my favourite toy as a kid. And then I have my... This is just all Pokemon. So I have blue boxed as well. Dave gave me these because he's an absolute champ. Blue, silver, leaf green, fire red, ruby and sapphire. I think he gave me blue and silver and ruby and sapphire boxed. These are, we already had these, and then I have Heart Gold and Soul Silver limited editions with the Pokewalkers, Sun and Moon, Alpha Sapphire, and Omega Ruby special editions too. And then the rest. So, yeah, and then I have like my old DS with Emerald in. Yeah, Emerald. Dusty, dusty. So yeah, some of my Pokemon stuff. I think there's just a touch more up there because I couldn't fit everything in. Next, I have my Copics. I haven't used my Copics in a while. I know a lot of you have noticed that, but mostly because I've been really into using wet media like inks and watercolours. So this is my display. This is just cardboard that Ryan brought home from a display at his job, and it just slots together. So if I can show you what it looks like when it's down sometime, you could probably make one yourself. And then I just cut it to fit in here, which is perfect. And then I've just got all my markers. They make nice noises. Then I've got some spare things that I got from a scroller box, etc. Some erasers, some watercolour erasers, mediums, masking fluid. It's a bit of a mess here. I've also got some Ravenclaw socks that Dave gave me. And some unfinished canvas boards because I'm not very good with acrylic. So yeah, just a few bits at the bottom, some acrylic paints here, yeah. This is my Canon Pixma Pro 10S. I love this printer, but it's a pain in the backside because it's broken. There's a glass of juice that I will move. The printhead appears broken, so I'm currently cleaning it out using rubbing alcohol. I was going to try and take the base off, however, one of the screws threaded, so it looks like I'm just going to have to replace the printhead full stop, which I really didn't want to do, but yeah, I've been keeping the printhead like face down so the ink drips down, and then I'm just going to keep cleaning it until it goes clear and then see how that works. But I definitely know it's a printhead issue. But this is an A3 printer. It prints up to A3 plus, I think, or just A3. It has two feeds. It has a rear feed and then a top loading feed, which is really good. Absolutely amazing. The inks are very expensive and there's 10 of them, but it's a very good printer. Then I have a little bookshelf. So I have some colouring books and some spare notebooks and address books on here. And then I have some reading books, my driving theory. I'm a really big fan of Beatrix Potter. I found these very ancient ones in a charity shop. I got all three for £1 each, not each, like all three came for £1, so like 33p. But Beatrix Potter is probably my biggest inspiration from my childhood. And so I keep copies of her work. This is a copy of my sketchbook that I did on Kickstarter. And then an older version of my book. One of my series of unfortunate events books. The rest are all still in storage. Because I have all the original hardbacks. I got this book that Mum got me called The Heart of Thomas. I've not read it, but she got it from a charity shop because she liked the look of it. I have my Legend of Korra art books. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't have the Avatar art book, but just the 4 Korras. The Art of Princess Mononoke. Buddhism book, The Art of Beauty and the Beast, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, an illustrated version that I'm really fond of that I had as a kid, The Brother Bear art book, Cartoon Modern, which was my biggest inspiration in uni. I fully recommend that book. The World History of Animation, one of my favourite books as well, because I'm really interested in animation history. Pokemon sticker book that Ryan got for me once, Animal Anatomy, a samurai book that my nana bought me, and then Japanese ink painting that I got for my birthday last year. Not last year, the year before. Then I have some spare sketchbooks. Japanese, the Alien comic, thanks to Andreas. And some folders, The Art of Pocahontas. I chucked out the dust cover because it was so torn. It arrived like that when I originally bought it, and I just thought, you know what, I'm not going to sell it. And then The Art of Persona 4, which is so good, I love it so much. And then I have some folders down here. So I have like animation reference library stuff. I made my own animation reference library with a lot of references in. It's incredible. I love it so much, and I only printed out half of what I was going to print in the end. But yeah, so I have, yeah, some little stuff. And one of my favourite books as a child, Little Polar Bear Finds a Friend. And the style of the story is actually very similar to how I now write stories, so it's fun going back to my old childhood stories and then seeing just what an influence they were on me. So it's pretty incredible. Just realised I forgot to do this shelf under here. So I have a talking puppy cat. Combi, some mugs. I've got the Link Between Worlds Figma that Phil bought me. I have 2 links that Dave bought me. The Majora's Mask Nendoroid and the Isabelle Nendoroid. I love them so much. And then 2 of my favourite amiibos. So the Isabelle and the Wolf Link. And it's my Canada fun, so that's just spare change I've been gathering, so I can have a bit of fun when I get to Canada. And then some plushies in the back. That was my first Pikachu, and I love it so much. A Legend of Korra lunchbox that Andreas got me, and it's so good. I love it, I love it. And then, like I said, yeah, the rest is just junk, apart from this box of pigment markers that Winsor & Newton very kindly sent me. And I have yet to do a video on it, but I will. This box has my spare printer cartridges. And this box is full of stuff. And then this black box, I got the box itself for Christmas because people buy me really useful boxes as means of wrapping gifts because I am addicted to these boxes. The company is Really Useful Box. That's exactly what they're called. And they're amazing. Love them so much. This has got a lot of my Christmas stuff in, but I'm slowly turning it into a cosplay box. And then down there, I actually have a pile of gift art that I have yet to put in my scrapbook. And a fan. And then there's my old monitor. Rest in peace. And yeah, like I mentioned previously, this is a no-go zone. So, wow, I can't wait for the day I have to fix that. Anyway, so, moving on to here, I have my necklaces, and I have a lot, so I'm not going to go through each one, but some of my favourites are my gummy bear from Franey, my glam burger by Retro8Bit, my bumblebees from Punky Pins, I have chokers, I wear this one a lot, flower crown, you know, just things like that. Majora's Mask, and I have another Laura Howell under there that Phil commissioned of Opal. And then I have another jewellery thing. It doesn't hold as much, but this one was a gift from Mel, who I used to work with. Not the Mel that you guys know from my live streams. I used to work with a lady named Mel, and she makes things like this. And it makes such nice noises. It's just... And this was my favourite necklace until the chain broke, and I've yet to find a chain that I really like that matches it, so, but it was my favourite necklace and still probably is. I have a pearl spear which unfortunately got broken on the way home from London. My friend Matt made this, and it's actually based on pilot pearl rather than current pearl, because I want to cosplay the pilot version of pearl, and it looks so good. I love this. He just made it for me, like, what the hell, but I've broken it because it didn't fit in the car and I didn't realise until I got back. So, I keep my bags on the back of the door, so I have a lot. I have this bag, which I use mostly. This is by Naja Porter, and it's on Society 6, and it's gorgeous. I think her name's Naja Porter. I feel like that might be her name. We will see. Got a windfish bag that Max made. I got this bag that I got in Tokyo with little stamps of Pokemon on. Pierogi sent me this Zelda bag, which everything's gonna fall. It's gorgeous, and she also sent me a Zelda hat. And Ryan got me this one for Christmas. It's Dangerous to Go Alone, and it's printed by my friend Lee, who actually does print my work onto t-shirts for me. And there's also a SpongeBob bag that Matt got me. And then these are my keys. So I have a cookie cat, Hylian Sword and Shield. Mel sent me a Timmy's for Christmas. I love it so much because all I do is go on about Tim Hortons. I have a limb enhancer, wooden Totoro, club card. I never remember the name of these. A clippy thing. And it's all on a easy lanyard. Where can I put that? I'll put that in my bag. That's a good idea. They're normally hung up in the hallway. Oh, I also, on my bag, I have a Steven Universe lanyard that I got from Hot Topic. And I have a super 90s unicorn. Love it, love it, love it. And a tracer. And a Steven. So I have, this is my bag for the longest time, and I love this bag to death, but it needed to have a break because I'd used it for about 3 years. I have a lion keyring, an Enderman, a bullet bill, and some Pikachus. And there's just junk in there now. I have my Steven Universe hoodie and also my cheeseburger backpack. Oh, I love this thing. Even the cheese is a pocket. Oh my god. How cool is that? And the bun, the burger's fluffy. really well made, but it's massive, and you do get funny looks when you wear it, so don't wear it if you don't want to get stared at. These are my Royal Mail bags that have just arrived, so I have to put all my postage in these. And then this is a pile of to sort. I don't look at this. I have my suitcase for my conventions, and some little bits just randomly on top there. So on top of here, I've got some pots of pens, and I'm not really sure about keeping them here permanently. You can tell they've just been put, but I'm not really sure where I'm going to put them, because I wanted to put my drawing table on here for things to dry. But yeah, so I have things like, if you watch one of my videos, relaxing pen sorting, it's got me sorting through all of these pens. So I have these are like writing pens, gel pens, biros. These are pencils. I've got some spare black wings now. Thank you, Mel, you saved my life. Some rulers, some extra pens, and little V-shaped glass. I have all my spare brush pens, like ink brush pens that need to be kept upright. I have some spare inking pens and my colouring pencils, which are Derwent Colour Soft. And yeah, I have this tub of Mauern, which I have not really had a few, but they are going to be put in orders. And I have a basket full of my snacks, so I have some of my teas. I have organic green tea, calming tea infusion, chamomile, lime flowers, and lavender. I have chamomile, and I have, I think this is peppermint, yeah. And I have some Hotel Chocolat tea infused with chocolate. I have my skinny mint that I'm going to go on soon, and some candy canes for my tree, and that chocolate coin. Then this here's my goodie box. I have some fudge and some chocolate that I keep in there. No, I can't get it back in. Go me! I have some spare tea. Back cookie cutter that Mel sent me. Some chocolate stuff in a little basket. And I have this old tub of inks that I'm probably going to chuck out because I don't use them. And then all my Copic Various inks as well, which line up so nicely in here. Like, look at that. So good. Under here I have some spare boxes. I have some spare really useful boxes. I have my drawing desk here. This has like my paper cutters and stuff like that in, like paper punches. Then I have my old inking box for like my Chinese ink. I've got an Ashens patch. That should be in my jewellery box, actually. I have my Japanese brushes. And under here, oh, this is a project and a half. So, I receive a lot of stuff in scroll boxes, and I used to get Sketchbox as well when I was part of Channel Frederator. This is a box of things that I have got from Sketchbox, scroller box, and also stuff off my old marker stand. And also things that Windsor & Newton have sent me, and oh my stars, I am so excited to go through this. I think I'm going to film going through it. Another sort of relaxing pen type thing. Oh my gosh, I've got so much. Wow! So much. I'm not even going to try and go through that right now, but I will do a video if you'd like me to. So, oh, I'm sat on my chair now. This is easier. My Christmas tree is just hanging in the back there. I have a box that I'm collecting here that I'm going to do a giveaway for, and it's just some spare art supplies. So some of them pens in that box that I just showed you are probably going to end up in here. Just some old... Some of them have been slightly used, but there's no point in me chucking them out. And I think some people would really benefit. There's some like little sketchbooks that I've never used, some ink that I've never used, some watercolours that I've used once because I already had some, and I just think someone else would benefit from them. So I'm going to fill up that box and do a giveaway on it. And I have my Christmas decorations in there, and then some files and stuff in there. Okay, so this is my other set of drawers. I have two sets of drawers here, and these contain a lot of my art supplies. So this is probably what you guys have been waiting for. I'm like, look at my walls, look at my Overwatch post, and you're like, will you get to the art? So, I'll go along the top. Have some little collectible stuff here. Print by Audra, you can't really see it, it's Cora Nasami, and I just love it so much. It slipped down in the frame, which makes me sad, so I need to go in and fix it up. And then another Jasper original by Brogan. And then I collect Iwako erasers, which are the puzzle erasers that you might have seen in shops, and I absolutely adore them. I used to collect erasers as a child, and people would laugh at me, and then I found out that it's a pretty big deal in Japan to collect erasers, and so I'm really happy because I can collect erasers again. And I have like food themed ones. My favourites are the food themed ones and the object ones. So I have like fries and burger and stuff. It's so cute. And I have like a little tape and scissors and a Kakashi doll. And then I have this lion that Ryan got me for Christmas, and he has toe beans, and I just lost it on Christmas morning. Look at that. I also collect actual Kokeshi dolls, so I have the old fashioned ones, and I have some newer styled ones, and then I have a Tifa just randomly in there. And normally on this desk is Steven the succulent, named by my mother. And he needs watering though, so he's shooting up some new leaves, which is really cute. So he kind of wilted a bit over winter, so I think he's picking up again. Okay, so this is my other chest of drawers that I very much love. And in the top I have completed or sometimes work in progress artwork. So I have some of these you might have seen in my videos, and these are originals that I'm either not selling because I am too proud of them, like this malachite. I'm really proud of how I did this, and the reason I won't sell it, even though I've made prints, is that the print didn't come out anywhere near as nice. So maybe I need to go get it scanned in professionally. I have some Witch Mercy prints that need to get sent out. I have a signed, this is the voice actor of Sokka, and Matt got this signed at SDCC. I have a very old Jasper sketch. I have some original, I think they are inked originals. I can't quite tell. I'm fairly certain they are. Because they kind of look like the paper that I also print on, but I was going to transfer completely traditionally at least the inking part at one point, so I decided against that. So I'm actually going to sell off these pages, and you can read my comics for free online. And there's the printed sketch pages. Here's my Cora Nasami, which I'm still unsure on whether I'm going to sell or not. I have some commissions that I've done, and I need to contact people for addresses and stuff. My collab with Bailey J. My jade that I'm going to do as a giveaway because I can't sell it. And a commission. A screenshot. Some doodles, some other stuff. Some of these originals are still up to sell my online store. Oh my gosh, I can't hold all this stuff. Like, I was really proud of this Wick painting that I did, so I don't want to sell her. And other bits as well. These are sold, like I said. And there's my temple piece. Some moon painting. Ruby and sapphire that I refuse to sell. Amaterasu that I no longer want to sell. My Jasper zine piece is going to mull and my unfinished cluster. And then over here I have some smaller stuff. These are actually a friend's watercolors that I need to send off. I have a malachite, the lapis sketchbook I did in the video. The reason these haven't been sent off yet, like I said, it was for the bloody postage mark thing. Follow me on Twitter if you kind of want to know the details. Some old originals that I have sold now. What else? Some commissions. One more crossing. Some old stuff that I didn't finish, and then some more commissions that I took at MCM that I'm waiting on sending out still, so I don't trust the postal system. And then I have a blindfold Totoro. Wow, flashback! My Galaxy Girl. One of my Stefani pieces that I don't like. Bismuth that I never finished, Boom Puppy Cat. And a little desk planner. And I have an opal oil painting that I want to revive at some point. It's very difficult to oil paint. It just takes too long to dry. So, the next drawer is my completed sketchbooks. And I also have some Canadian visa documents. Some mount board. This is like a little box of just bits. This is, yep, my old sketchbooks that you saw in my sketchbook tour video. So most of these are 2016. Oh, I've got a drawing from Andreas and a bank statement. From a bank that I don't use anymore. Yep, all my completed sketchbooks that you saw in that video. Sorry if I'm losing my voice now. A little sketchbook that Andreas drew me. Totally legit Jellybee sketchbook. There's a malachite sketchbook that I love very much as well. If you want to see those sketchbooks a lot more in depth, go check out my sketchbook tour video. This is like my little technology drawer. I have a Huon graphics tablet that I need to do a review video for. Every time I go and film it, I don't like it, and I'm so bad. I have some straighteners. I don't actually use these for my hair. They're actually for sealing up blind bags that I use to sell off like old stuff. I have my umbrellas for my lights. Some wires, some like there's a stand from my Blue Yeti. I have some hard drives and some other bits. An iPhone tripod mount. Yeah, my 3DS charging dock because I'm old school. And in here I have convention stuff. So let's knuckle down and get in here. So this is going to be I'm actually going to go in that box, the giveaway box, because no one claimed it. So I have Manga Studio, some letters, some other bits. Sorry if you hear my chair squeaking. In here I have some spare stuff for making my charms. So I have some old charms in the middle and up there, and then I have some earrings that I made, and some hair clips and other hair grips that I made and stuck gems on. Yeah, and then in this one I have all of my precious stones that I use to make my charms. So I accidentally bought really tiny pearls and I don't know what I'm going to do with them. And I also have some real pearls that are the actual size that I needed. And some dust plugs and some head pins. So we have garnet, amethyst, not quite sure what that one. One of them will be lapis lazuli. Yeah, okay, you can see them better now. So we have garnets. I couldn't get garnets in this size. Amethysts, lapis lazuli, peridot, because that's how we pronounce the actual gem over here. I know her name is Peridot, but the stone to us is peridot. So I call the character Peridot and the stone peridot. Rose quartz, brown zebra, jasper, and pearls, and then, yeah, dust plugs, jump rings, and head pins. Then in here I have my charms that I made that I mentioned earlier. So I have like Pearl, Steven, I have everyone basically, except fusions and other characters like Bismuth and the rubies. I don't have those, but yeah, I have the main ones. And then there's some gems down there that I make into earrings. And all of these are my earrings that I haven't yet stuck down. So that each one is individually wrapped so far. But, let me show you. If I can get into this. No, I can't get into it one-handed, so... Sorry guys, maybe another day, but yeah, each earring charm is individual. I have some little frames that I do originals in for conventions. I have some note cards, a BMO canvas that I never finished, some Rilakkuma stamps, a pancake that Nikki made me, and some extra convention bits like chalkboard, pegs, pins, friends, business cards, kind of thing. So I have mailing bags that I use for Lucky Dip print bags, and I just put a sticker over the front, and people can't see what they get, which is really cool. Some random pliers that shouldn't be in there, and some spare moleskin books, all my artist trading cards, and some old artwork. And I didn't finish. And that's in there. Then I have... So I have like empty cases. So these are my 272 Copic cases, which I don't use at the moment. And they are the official ones as well. I have two of those. An old pencil case and a compass thing. A high-vis jacket because some conventions require it. Another Copic case. I have the box from a Pearl Pop vinyl, and all the boxes for mine, Androids and Figmas, because they're very collector friendly and you can put everything back. So yeah, I have my Link Between Worlds Figma, Isabelle Nendoroid, two Link Nendoroid, and Majora's Mask Nendoroid. Love Nendoroids very much. Okay, so next. And I think this might be the last thing. Oh my stars. So, okay. This is going to be very in-depth, and this does contain a lot of stuff. So like I said, buckle in. Start with the top, there's Steven the Succulent. We have some plasters that I just grabbed out because I cut my finger during a live stream. And I just picked up some discounted gouache and watercolours from Hobbycraft. They were really cheap. And then I got like a 50p canvas palette. This is my Epson Perfection V39 scanner. It doesn't require a power cable. It just plugs in via USB, and it is an incredible scanner. It's absolutely amazing. It's about £70 to £80 if you can get one. I really recommend it. I prefer Epson for scanners. I don't like Canon scanners. I don't like HP scanners. I like Epson. So, squeaky chair. So I have my watercolour jar, and I'm going to pull this out because to get to anything you have to pull it out, but it's nice to tidy them all away. So I have a spare palette that I've used for gouache recently. I have my Fintech palette, which is all my gold metallic inks. You can check this out on my Lapis Lazuli video and pretty much every video. I have my Buddy Cup palette by Frisk. And these are like extras. You can buy these little tubs extra, and they've got they've got a lot of my inks in, but some of them need cleaning out. Let's pop that in there. I have a goat's hair brush. I don't actually buy a lot of I don't buy any animal hair brushes, but I needed something quickly at the time, so I got goat's hair, unfortunately. Art Discount Artist's Blue Mask. I used to work for Art Discount. And these are some brushes I've just used recently. This is my favourite brush of all time, which is the Graduate De La Rowney number 4 round, and it's a long handle. It's beautiful, it's my favourite. And then I have, as you can see in here, this is all my brushes. Can't really get into it. Oh, yeah, I can. Okay, put that one back. And that one. So, yeah, I have all my brushes. I have these rubber shaders that I actually use to apply masking fluid, which is why they're all gungy and gross. But it's better than gunging up a brush. And yeah, just lots of brushes. I've got a toothbrush that I use to speckle white paint. And then I have some of my gouache tubes. My mop brush, which I used for the first time the other day. But yeah. Let's pop that back. Oh no. Okay. So I have an empty Fine-Tech palette. And some more of the body cups with gouache in. Then I have this little tub here, which just fits in really nicely. Again, really useful boxes. Just, oh, that's so good. This tower is a really useful box tower. This is a really useful box. This is a really useful box. I have a lot. And some more gouache tubes. I use Winsor & Newton designer's gouache. I have some spare erasers. These are my favourites. They are the Faber-Castell Dust Freeze. And they are absolutely incredible. They're my favourite. I have a pencil sharpener. And a spare putty eraser. And then I have this. You know what this is? This is my watercolours. This is my baby. And yeah, I have the Winsor & Newton Cotman 45 Studio Set. I love this thing so much. I have stickers on it that I've got from like Redbubble. My friends gave me these. Yeah, I've got a Jasper. Jasper Point. Let's get this back in. Okay, this is like Tetris, okay? This is careful. And then that one goes there. And then... okay. Yay! It's all back in. Let me just put it back in properly. Okay, the red drawer has some of my current sketchbooks. So I have the blank book, which is my blank comic book. A lot of you guys wanted to know where this was, and I'll put an Amazon link in the description. This is my pretty much done sketchbook now. It's pretty much gone. Currently I'm using a new version of the same book, which is the Moleskine Art Plus Enlarge. Then I have my two current A4 sketchbooks, which need filling in, like my Gemsonas. Yeah. And then under here, I have decided that my New Year's resolution is to practice backgrounds. So I have a sketchbook that I'm going to do every other day with backgrounds and see how much better I get over the year. And this was referenced from Hong Kong, and then I added things to do with my comic into it. I've only done the one for now. This should probably be in here, but I mean, I sketch so much. No, I'm just going to leave it out. The next drawer is a mix. I have these two figures here that are Persona 4 figures, and they were gifts, but the stands, I've lost the stands. So Some little gift earrings and necklace and stuff. Some badges that I've been given as a gift or that I've bought. Some of my 3DS games. Some correction tape that I bought. It says happy little face and that one's got a brew on it. Ooh. That's my tub of... Let me get that out. Okay, wait. There's a Tombow pen, Tombow Fudenosuke, which is my favourite inking tool. And then these came extra with some dust, those dust plugs that I ordered. There's a really sweet seller on Etsy. Some batteries for my lights. One of my Steven Universe pencil cases. That one's Joe Quinn's. And then I have some spare holofilm, spare command hooks, some spare medication. And then in this envelope I have my money bags. And I have some sticky notes. I live on sticky notes. Big gay postcard. Blue tack. So here are some of my stickers. The majority of my stickers are actually in my planner, which I will go in depth at the end of the video. I'm going to go in depth into a few other bits. So, my stars isn't going to go back together, is it? This is such a good idea. Tidy my room for a solid week, get it all in order, and then trash it. Woo! It's the punk lifestyle, guys. Are you an art punk? There goes Rise. Okay. Oh. Oh my. So, next one down is my nail varnish drawer. And my favourite nail varnishes are like grey coloured ones and like this olive coloured one. And then I like to use things like gold glitter. This one's one of my favourites as well. It's like, if you can see it, it's pink with gold glitter. I have this one, which is like headcanon pearl colour. And it dries super fast. OPI yellow. OPI red. Hardener. Top coat. Glitter glue. Yeah, just... lots and lots of nail varnish. This is one of my favourites and it has like actual stars in. We get a bit of focus. Yeah. You can just see the stars, but the stars stick out a bit too much and they pop off. And I really like this one. Oh, look at that. Yeah, I have some Halloween nail stickers. I don't want to use them for Halloween exclusively. I feel like someone would be like, ew, where have you got Halloween nails? And then I've got one of these plates. I got them ages ago. Gosh, a couple of years ago now. And they've never worked. I've never found a good enough nail varnish. Oh, there's the camera. I've never found a good enough nail varnish. So, I just don't know what to do. I've got these stick-on nails that I got for like 50p. And then at the back I have more stick-on nails. So, like... ones that you might have seen in my videos, actually, that I haven't thrown out. Ones I haven't used yet, because they're like a pound in Primark. So... it's so good. Like, blue ones, and I've got ones with, like, mermaids on, and stuff like that. Go back in! Go back in! Okay. That's gone gross. Lush. Yeah, I've got all the little tools for that plate scraping thing, and like loads and loads of the plates because they were so cheap, but it didn't work. And I don't, if anyone has any recommendations for what nail varnish to use, then please let me know. There we go. Okay, disclaimer, my floor looks dirtier on camera than it is in real life. I have hoovered this floor. My hoover's not very good. I've hoovered this floor to death, and the carpet is like black with speckles, and it drives me to the wall. So. Okay, I keep my spare pencil cases in here, so I have my pencil wrap, which has my watercolour pencils in. And my Sharpies. Ooh. And some ink tents there. Da 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 da. And I'm gonna put that on there because I can't wrap that back up with one hand. And I got this one for Christmas off Fiona. And it's gold and I love gold. I can't wear gold, but I like it. These are my inking tools. Yeah, the reason I can't wear gold, that was kind of random to say. I'm actually super allergic to gold, but I like the colour. But anyway, yeah, my inking tools are white inks and Tombows and then some clean colours. And then, like I said, Fiona bought me that pencil case full of pens, and these were the pens. I put them in here because I love this case so much. I got this in Hong Kong when I first visited, and I was 17. Had this pencil case 10 years. And the reason I like it is because it's all mesh inside. It's really nice. Loads of these! The Zig Clean Color Real Brushes, and they're so beautiful, and she's beautiful, and thank you so much, Fiona. I was trying not to cry, and then I punched her because she spent money on me. I didn't, like, punch her in the face. That sounds harsher than it actually was. I kind of, like, nudged her. I was like, you can't do this. But, yeah, it's got some spare markers in there as well. So, unfortunately, I had to finish filming last night before I'd actually finished filming. So, this is going to be a bit of a weird cut. I do apologise. My battery died and it was about 11:30 and I got really tired and I was trying to wait to film, but it just kept getting later and later. And anyway, so we were up to here. I have the birds with me today in this room. So, and I've had my lunch and stuff, so I'm sorry if you see extra bits. Anyway, this drawer has some spare paper. It's got like cut down paper, some cards and envelopes. Like folded cards, and then all under here is my Copic Express It blending card because I got so much and I love it. And there's a Lowish bookmark that came with the Kickstarter. What else? I think there's some mount board as well. Yeah, there's some board, but yeah, not really much interesting in that one. Then I have my bookbinding drawer, which has all the stuff for my bookbinding when I get to do it. I have like glue spreaders, hole punches. These boards I was going to make into a mini book press. I have a larger one. Have some things like ribbons, beeswax for threading, for threads, so that you pull it through like this thread thing, and it waxes your thread, which is really cool. Have some very strong glue, more glue spreaders, more ribbon, and then all of this is like pre-cut board, which I like traditional bookbinding. I know that you can do like simple bookbinding, but I really like stitching it. It's very therapeutic, but I never get time to do it. And the bottom drawer is a junk drawer. What a surprise! So I have like, this had Pokemon cards in. I have some bits of paper, Christmas decorations. I've got fabric for my bookbinding. Origami budgie that Andreas did for me. It keeps falling off the wall. Some paint. Some more batteries, some more buddy cups that shouldn't be in here. I've got a bag of sour Skittles for some reason. This little box of buttons that I used to use for my website, which is really weird, but I used to make my website look like a desk. So I took photographs. Oh, sorry. I've got some private letters, and then there's my Majora's Mask book that I did a long time ago. I don't even know if I'd was I on YouTube then when I did that? I can't remember. Yeah, I've got some Star Wars fabric, some Space Invader fabric, and some with sushi on, and they're really cute, and they're just fat quarters. So the last thing I was going to do was just quickly run through my planners. Obviously, I'm not going to show you any personal information or anything that might be, like, spoilers for what I'm doing for the future. But, yeah, so I organise this one for my like my YouTube and my work life, and then my little ones for personal. So I'll just flip through this one. I've got some paper clips and a business card. I've got some spare money in here just in case I ever need it. and some stickers in there, and tabs, and planner stickers. Ghibli planner stickers are really cute. This is my wallet full of, like, stickers that I mentioned earlier. Yeah, it's got a lot of stickers in it. And then, so I have my YouTube goals, which are there, which I'm not going to show you guys because it's embarrassing. And then I have this paper, which is for YouTube notes. Commission lists, so things from Twitch. Icons, I haven't updated this list. And then this commission that I've forgotten whose it was. And now I can't remember whose it was. And now I don't know who to send it to. And then I have, like, my undated planner here, which I just fill in when I can. I don't push myself to fill it in if I can't do it. And then I don't waste paper as well. Then I have addresses, obviously not going to show you those. Notes, so I've got, like, an A3 print count. More notes about character design. Stock lists. Right at the back, I actually have a like my old notes and stuff. And then here I have a Valentine's card. And then I have a birthday card for someone. Like my loan information, my business loan information. And a little highlighter and a pen, and that's mostly all of that. And I have these two little keyrings. And that one's from Paper Chase. And then my personal information one, obviously not going to show you a lot of this, but I really like the organizer itself. So I keep my medication in there, and then I can track it a little bit easier. And I have, like, plastic tabs. Oh, I love them so much. I've got stickers on the front, and then I have, like, a month on two pages diary, which is really nice. So I've written down, like, people's birthdays and conventions. And then I have a to-do list, which I cleared out and put fresh sheets in for this year. I have budgets, so that's how much I earn. A diary. So I have at the front, I need to track my mood for my bipolar disorder. So I have mood stickers, and I draw a little face on each start and stick it in, and then I think you can just see one there. So, yeah. And again, I have undated sheets in this so that I don't feel pressured to fill it in when I don't have to. Contacts, so more addresses, and then notes at the back, which I can't show you because it's to do with tax information. And then some religious festivals and stuff like that in the back, and spare separators, and then another pen. So those are my organisers, because I need to have an organised life. But yeah, thank you for watching my workstation tour of 2017. I hope I didn't talk too fast. I hope it was enjoyable. I tried to get in as much as possible. And yeah, thank you so, so much for watching. And I hope to see you in my next video. Bye. Hi everyone, welcome to my updated work tour.